I give the floor to International Career Support Association.
Thank you, Madam Vice President. The Republic of Korea's Supreme Court rules Japanese company must pay compensation to the Koreans for having been forced into the labor during World War II. Koreans who worked for the Japanese companies at the time chose to work seeking a good wages based on their own will. Mobilization of the Korean Japanese nationals for a mere 6 months was not forced and entirely within the international law. The compensation between Japan and ROK was resolved completely and finally by the Japan-ROK agreement signed in 1965. The Japanese Supreme Court also ruled an individual demand is nullified. Demanding compensation from the Japanese companies based on the Korean Supreme Court ruling is tantamount to revoking the legally binding treaty signed between two nations, which violating the Japan's sovereignty and trampling upon the rights of the Japanese people. Korean Minister of Foreign Affairs Kang Kyung-hwa addressed at this council last year and last week, repeatedly violating the same treaty and additional bilateral treaty signed in December 2015 related to the comfort women issue. Treaty is a promise between two nations. Even Kiss knows a breaking promise is wrong. Before talking about the comfort women issue, Kang Kyung-hwa needs to apologize to the victims of the sexual violence committed by the South Korean troops during the Vietnam War and the victim-centered measures. Why this council is quiet to the nation who always violates the bilateral treaties? We demand this council to instruct South Korean government to immediately undertake the measure to correct their anti-diplomatic relations and sincerely apologize to the Vietnamese victim called Lai Dai Han. I thank you very much for your attention, Madam Vice President.
Thank you.